Hello everyone, welcome back to the video series of the Object Oriented Programming with Java. Our today's topic for this particular video, that is the inheritance, types of inheritance and method overriding. I am your instructor Mr. Ankit Patel. So let's start with the today's outline. So outline for the today's lecture, that is a introduction to the inheritance, types of inheritance and method overriding. So I will discuss all these three topic with the examples. So let's start with the introduction to the inheritance. So first of all, what do you mean by the inheritance? So inheritance means if one class can access the property of another class, this is known as an inheritance. So here the concept of the object oriented programming tells like we can reuse the data. Now up to the programming session, I have already seen the programming how to access the data of one class and what is the procedure to access the data of the member of the class. Now here, using the concept of inheritance, there are the multiple class in our single program, and if you want to use the data of one class to other class, then this concept is known as an inheritance. So we can say like that, in inheritance the new class is created by some property of the old class. So here we can create a new class by using some data of the old class. So this concept is similar, by which a subclass are created using the some property of the superclass. And the main use of the inheritance is base class data can be reused in the subclass. So it is also known as an easy relationship. Now inheritance is not a concept like you have to use whenever the class wants to access the data of some another class, then that particular subclass that have to use all the data of superclass is not like that in inheritance. You have the option whenever you are just accessing the data of class, you can access some data of the class, you can access all the data of the class, right? So there is no any kind of restriction, there is no any kind of concept that you have to use all the data of that particular class. So that is known as an inheritance. Simply inheritance is this concept tell we can reuse the data in our subclass. So now what are the different types of inheritance available in the Java? So these are the types. First step, that is a single inheritance is there. I will explain all these different types with the examples. So the first step, that is a single inheritance. Second, that is a multi-level inheritance. Third one, that is a hierarchical inheritance. Next, that is a multiple inheritance is there. And the last one, that is a hybrid inheritance. So these are the types of inheritance I will discuss with the programming. Now next topic in this particular session, that is a single inheritance. So single inheritance means what? Here this is a simple form of the inheritance is there, in which a one superclass there and one subclass is there. Now you can see this structure below. Here the class A and class B is there. B can access the property of class A. So that is known as a single inheritance is there. So here one superclass and one subclass is there. Now next, that is a multi-level inheritance is there. So in multi-level inheritance case, the subclass is derived from the superclass and which itself derived from some other class. That is, this type of structure is known as multi-level inheritance. You can see in the viewer, here the three classes there, A class, B class and C class. Here B can access the property of A class and C can access the property of B class. This concept is known as a multi-level inheritance. Next concept, that is a hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance in which the structure in hierarchical is in the form of the tree type structure is there. One root node is there and there are the different leaf node is there. Now in this form of inheritance where one or more class are derived from the common base class. You can see the structure here, the A class, B and C class is there. B and C both can access the property of A class. This is known as an hierarchical inheritance. Next, that is a multiple inheritance. In the case of the multiple inheritance, Actually, the concept is not supported in the Java, but we can implement this type of structure using the concept that is known as an interface. So, if someone asks which object-oriented concept is not supported in Java, the answer is the multiple inheritance. But we can implement this structure like multiple inheritance means suppose in the figure you can see that class ABC is there, C can access the both the property of A and B. Right, if you want to implement this type of structure, you need to use a concept that is called as an interface, and that we will discuss in my next video. So, and the last type, that is a hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance, that is a combination of any two types of inheritance. So when two or more types of inheritance are combined together, then it's form an hybrid inheritance. So these are the types of inheritances there. I will discuss all these with the live programming. And the next topic, that is the method overriding, is there. Now, what do you mean by the method? I have already told about the method overloading. In method overloading, within a same class, there are the multiple method is there with the same name but different signature. But in method overriding, the one method that is available in the super class and that also available in the subclass with the same signature, this structure is known as a method overriding. So when a method in a subclass has the same name and signature as a method in its superclass, and the method in a subclass is said to override the method in a superclass. So this concept is called as method overriding, and that's always this involve the inheritance, because without the concept of inheritance, it is not possible to override the method. So method overriding occur when a class declare a method that has the same type of signature as method created by one of its superclass. So that concept is known as a method overloading. So hope you understand this theoretical concept. I will explain all these types of inheritance as well as method overriding with the programming. So without wasting so much time, let's start the programming. Now in this session, I will show you the example of the different types of inheritance as well as method overriding. So let's start the first one, that is a single inheritance, the example of the single inheritance. So now I am creating the simple class, class A is there, A class. I am just giving the name class A class. Now in that particular class, I am just declaring one variable A is equals to 10. Now one class I am creating, that is a B class. Now in that particular class, I am creating a one variable, that is a B is equals to 20. Now just I want to add these two variable, so I am just using a one add method is there, and I am just writing integer C that is equals to A plus B. Now then I am printing this data system dot out dot println, add is equals to, I am just printing the value C. Now I am creating the main class here, that is a demo class is there. You can name whatever you want to. Now the public static void main is there, string args. Let's save this particular file first of all, demo.java. So here I have saved that particular file with the demo name because the main is available in the demo class. Now I just want to create the object of B class. Here the B1 that is equals to new B class. I have created that particular class. Now I want to just call this method add method. If you save and run that particular program, but now here one error is generated by the compiler that B is undefined. Why that error is generated? Because we have A is undefined because there is no declare a variable A in B class. So we need to just reuse that data. So you have to use the keyword that is extends. Extend the name of the class. So by using this statement, like using this keyword extend the class name, now here the B, that is a subclass of the A class. Now here the B class can access the data of A class. Now you can easily access here the A. Now if you run this code, now I will show you the example here. I am just small down this window so you can easily check it out. Now you can see here my data is stored in a B drive and J folder is there. Now let's compile this javac demo.java. So you can see the output here, java demo. You can see the addition is equals to 30. This will print it. So now here the data we are using, that is of the A class. So inheritance, that concept tells the data reusability. So we can reuse that data. So this is the concept of the single inheritance. Now suppose if you want to implement the concept of the multi-level inheritance, I am just declaring a one class, that is a C class is there, right? So here C class that extend B class, okay? So here the structure is created like this. I want to just use the data of A class to B class and B class to C class. So I am just removing this method. Here I am deleting that particular method. So what we have created? I have created one variable in A class, one variable in the B class. Now in C class, I am just declaring a one variable integer C. And just copy paste that particular method, add C is equals to A plus B, and just printing the value. Now here C can access the data of B class because C is a subclass of B class. But here the C can also access the data of A class because indirectly C, that is a child of B, and B, that is a child of C. Like grandfather is there, father is there, and child is there. So child can access, also access the property of grandfather. So you can easily access that data. So now in main class, I am just creating the object of C class. Like C1. You can take the name, any name. I am just creating the name C1. Now if you run this file again, if you run this data again, java c demo.java and java demo, you can see the addition is equals to 30. Now if you change this value, suppose if you have doubt, just change this value here 50 and then compile and run it again. You can change the changeable output is there. So here this is the example of the multi-level inheritance. Now let's take another example that is called as an hierarchical. Now in case of hierarchical, we have an option like A class data we can also use in a B class, as well we can also use in a C class. So here we just need to write down, like this only change is there, here we need to write down just A is there. What we have changed? Here extend B class before we have written. Here I am writing only the extend A class. So here the structure, like B can also access the property of A class and C can also access the property of A class. Now here C cannot access the property of B class because B and C class are the sibling of the A class. So you here suppose if you are right, if you want to use a B variable, at that time it will generate an error. So I am just displaying this value. I am just displaying the value of A here, right? Here I am just displaying the value of A here. Here the A is equals to 10 is there. Now you can change this value over here directly, like A is equals to 100. You can access this variable by only because here the C, that is a subclass of A variable. And same kind of code I am written in the B class. There is no use of the initialization of B variable. I am just removing the variable B. So what we are similarly, there is a no use of the C class over here. So I am deleting that particular line also. Now you can see what we have made. I am just using the variable A, using this variable A in a B class as well as in C class. In a B class, I am just assigning a variable A to 200. In a C class, I am just assigning a variable A to 100. So now if you want to print this data, you just need to create the object of B class as well as C class. So here B class, I am creating the object B1, that is equals to new B class, and that B1 dot add. So you can see this data easily. You can see what we have written. Suppose if you want to access the B class data, then you need to create the object of B class. I have already created. If you want to access the data of C class, then we have created the object of C class. Now let's run it again. So what is the output of this code? So first it will print a 100, then it will print a 200. Let's compile this code. And so add is equals to 100 and add is equals to 200. So this is a simple example. I am not creating any logical program. I am just explaining you the structure of the types of inheritance. And that structure we can use in the different programming. Suppose now one program, like if you want to find the area of circle is there, one circle class is there, in subclass you want to find out the area of the circle class, then you can reuse the radius of the parent class. So you can make that type of program. So in this particular video, I am not trying to explain about the exact programming. I am just giving the simple demo program of the different types of inheritance. So what is the structure of the single inheritance, simple multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance is there. And lastly, the example that I have already told you, the which concept is not supported in Java, that is a multiple inheritance. Now multiple inheritance, suppose what do you mean by the multiple inheritance? Now suppose you hear the A class and B class is there, and C can extend both the data, A class as well as the B class. Now suppose if you are making this type of statement, obviously the compiler will generate an error. I am just removing this variable over here. I am not just printing anything, because I am just want to use this concept. Obviously this concept is not supported in Java, so this will generate an error. Let's see what type of error will be displayed. Let's compile it. You can see one error is there. Yes. The error is expected. Closing bracket is expected. Class C class extend A class. Over here, what it tell? This requires the closing. This is not so that the multiple inheritance is not supported in Java. This type of message will not printed. But this so that there is something mistake over here. Okay. So because this concept is not supported, we are just removing it. And the last one, that is a hybrid inheritance is there. Now hybrid inheritance, that is a we can combine any type of like multi single inheritance as well as the hierarchical inheritance. Here the A class, here the A class, B class, and C and D class is there. Like B class can access the property of A class. Here the C and D, both class can access the property of B class. This type of structure is known as a hybrid inheritance. The hybrid, this is the combination of any two types of inheritance. This is known as an hybrid inheritance. And the last topic in this particular programming session, that is a method overriding. So I am just removing this class, C class is there. So I am just removing C class. Now, what we want? I just want to print the method, just use the concept that is a method overriding over here. So now I am creating the one method that is a void show. In that particular method, I am just printing the method system.out.println. And I am writing the simple message, that is a class method. Okay. Now same method I am just writing over here in a B class. I am just writing a same method, but I am just changing this method here, A class in replace, I am just writing a B class method. So normally this will behave like a each and every class have the method, so method is there. Now if you want to print a class, so this is not a concept of method overriding. Now if you want to just implement the concept, then you need to just inherit that particular class, a class. What happened over here? Here the a class, the memory of this same b void, so here the b class that override that particular method. So have the same signature in a subclass, same signature of the super class. That method is called as an overridden method. Now if you want to print this a class method, because that method is overridden by the b class, you cannot call it with the using of the b class object like b1.so. If you want to print this line, what will be the output? I will show you. First of all, it will print the data of the extend b class is there, extend c class is a class is there. Now let's compile it. What will be the output? Let's compile first of all. Here it will generate error like we are expecting some semicolon is there. We have missing a double quotation over here. That's why it will generate an error. Now let's compile it, and if you check this, what will be the output over print over here? It will print only the B class data, not A class data. Now if you want to print the A class data, you need to just create the object of the A class, that is equals to new A class, and just write down A1.show. So this is the example of the method overriding. We have just printing mistake is there. You can see B class as well as A class. So hope you understand that this programming session of these today's lecture. So what we have explained in this particular video, that is the types of inheritance and method overriding. So this is the end of the programming session. So thank you very much. If you have any doubt, you can feel free to ask me. Thank you very much.